The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
Live from Carlisle, Ohio, home of Armed Radio. This is Unscheduled with Les Scammo in the day. I want to thank everybody that's in the military and all around the world. I just thank you. God bless you. I'm praying for you. And all you first responders and doctors and EMTs all of you in the medical field. Special shout out to the 88th Medical Group in Wright-Patterson Air Force Base. David's been taking care of me for all these years. God bless you. I love you. Thank you for what you're doing. Not only for me, but for servicemen all in the area. I think I sucked bird down coming in, Dave. People come from all over the United States to go to Wright-Patterson. I've talked to them from all over the place that come there just for different treatments and things. So God bless you and we love you. And, folks, this is Armed Radio with Les Scammo today. You can also go on Armed Radio Group News on our Facebook page. And there's a complete lineup of our shows. You can go through our selection. You can click on the marquee, and it'll take you right to their show, pre-recorded show. And if you want to see what their show is like and listen to the recorded previous show. Also, you can download the TuneIn app. And if my Facebook goes out, all you got to do is click on that TuneIn app link there that I have on there, and it will take 1-800-508-5431. If you want to engage in the program, just be civil. That's all I ask, and we'll give you time to get your point across, whether you're for us or against us. And I missed anything, Dale? Yes, I did. We're also archived on iHeartRadio, and we're also archived on Spotify. So you can go to either one of them places, and you can get all of our previous show. Easy for me to say. Previous shows. And get a call tonight, 1-800-508-5431. It's toll-free. And anywhere in the world, give us a call. And Dave, I tell you what, dang on. First thing I want to hit is that, did you hear Portland last night during Indigenous Peoples Day of Rage, Antifa called it. They tore down a Abraham Lincoln statue and they pulled down a Teddy Roosevelt statue. Folks, this is hate America is what this is all about. This ain't about Democrat or Republican, Dave. It's about destroying the foundation of this country. Those are Biden's people. Those are Harris's people out there doing this crap, folks. It's because they hate America. They call it a revolution. They want to destroy the Constitution. They want to tear down our history, just like ISIS did when they blew up the Buddha statues over there. And just like Stalin did, just like Kim Jong-un. They don't allow anything but statues and monuments to their leaders. And that's the same thing with the Antifa. and Black Lives Matter. They're all terrorist organizations, Dave, that hate this country. And you know what really frosted me was they only arrested three people. This happened in Portland, Dave. Now, why did they only arrest three people? Because the ones, and we said this before, Dave, why is this still going on in Portland? It's because the governor and because the mayor of Portland are cut from the same cloth. Folks, they're the same people. Every Democrat city that has been burnt to the ground and looted, black businesses burnt, Jewish businesses burnt, white people's businesses burnt, on top of COVID-19, okay? Those are Joe Biden's people. Those are Harris's people, Dave. That's who they are. They won't condemn them people. They won't come out against them people. It just sets me on fire. But it's still continuing out there. I don't know what degree. They've pretty much got a blackout on it anymore in the media, Dave. You can't hardly catch anything unless some independent gets some video and puts it on Facebook. But, folks, we cannot. We absolutely cannot allow Biden and Harris to win this election, Dave. You talk about a disaster. It's bad enough as things is, folks. But you won't have no future. If these two communists get in office, first of all, we know Joe Biden ain't going to be president. What's Nancy Pelosi doing? Everybody thinks it's about Trump, and it could be. But I believe that's a commission that Pelosi is trying to set up is more targeted to Joe Biden, David.
Well, the thing she's trying to set up is not constitutional, though. There's nowhere in the Constitution. The 25th Amendment calls for the president to be replaced by the vice president, but has to be agreeable by the vice president.
Yeah.
And the vice president, chances are, wouldn't agree with it. And then, well, it includes his whole cabinet.
Right.
The cabinet and the vice president have to agree to it that the president's not able to fulfill his duties as president. And then, done away with it, I think it takes like 2/3 majority in the Congress to take the president's power away from him. So it's kind of like it's a harder goal to get to than impeachment, even to remove the president, the sitting president, because what they are supposed to do is come to the president and ask him if he's able to continue on. If he signs a letter saying he is, then they disagree, then the whole cabinet has to come down against him, plus the vice president and the Congress has to have a 2/3 majority to take him out of office. So, like, if he lost his mind or if he was had a stroke or something, incapacitated, there's no way he could sign the paper saying that he was able to continue on. So therefore, it'd be pretty much self-explanatory that he would lose his office.
Right.
But the right. way she wants to do it is not constitutional.
Right.
So that's one reason I think the Supreme Court's so important to him, because they can't legislate from Congress because the American people won't go along with them. So what do? They go bypass their own self and go to the courts. That's how you got gay marriage. It's not in the Constitution. A man should marry a man or a woman should marry a woman. Or how about abortion? That's not constitutional.
Yeah.
There's nowhere in the Constitution where it says that. So when Amy Coney Barrett is before them tomorrow answering questions, and they ask her questions about abortion, she should answer and say, well, I'm going to look to the Constitution for that, the resolution of that particular case. And they'll look to themselves, well, it's not in the Constitution. There you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
Right.
How about gay marriage? Same thing. I want to look to the Constitution when it comes to areas of gay marriage. Well, it's not in the Constitution. See, all this stuff that it's done outside the Constitution, that's what a judge should not be as a legislator. And that's why Amy Coney Barrett is, if she follows true with Scalia, the type of judge that Scalia was, and we won't have any problems with her. I'll be happy with her decisions, because it's going to be based on the Constitution, not making up new law.
Right. And just like you said, that's why we have what we got today. And people say, well, it's legal. Well, it's legal. Okay, there's things that's legal, but it's unethical and it's unconstitutional. These things are legal for now, okay, but they have no foundation. What they're rooted in is a lie and deceit, okay? And I'll have no problem with her either. First of all, she's born again Catholic, okay? And she's a very, I hate to use the word religious, but she's very committed to her faith.
She's a spirit-filled Catholic.
She's a spirit-filled Catholic, who she is.
Which I like that.
Well, absolutely. You know,
I'd rather somebody be spiritual than religious.
Absolutely, yeah. You've seen what that cost Jesus.
Religion gets you nowhere. You know, being spiritual, close to God, or communicating with God. People scoff at it. Notice the religious people scoff at that.
When right.
You say you're spiritual and you hear from God.
Right.
They scoff at that. They say, oh, yeah, he's crazy.
You're nuts.
No, nobody hears from God. But just because you don't hear from God doesn't mean I don't hear from
right.
God. I hear from God a lot of different ways.
That's
you
right.
can read his word and he speaks to you that way. And you can read scriptures that you've read all your life and all of a sudden it occurs to you and you see something different that you didn't see before. What do you think that is?
Right.
Exactly. I mean, things that you've read over and over again, 100 times,
mm-hmm.
and all of a sudden you read it one day, and God speaks to you through that scripture, and you see something in it that you never saw before. How do you think that's not God speaking to you? Think about that for a second. That's what spirituality is, not religion. Religiosity is when you go to church, you expect something. You really don't expect anything. You just go out of obligation, and you go there over and over and over again. You really don't expect anything from God. It's just something you have to do religiously. We use religious, we do things religiously all the time. Like you go to work, you get up in the morning, your alarm clock goes off, you take a shower, you get something to eat, you pack your lunch, you go to work, you come home, you do the same thing, you watch a little TV,
yeah.
you go to bed. You do this religiously. You do it every day, the same thing every day. And, you know what they say about insanity? Albert Einstein said the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again, expecting a different result.
Right.
And you can't expect a different result if we continue down the road that the Democrats left
right.
us when Obama left office. If we continue down that road, go back to that road and go down it and expect a different result, we will not get a different result. The same thing will happen. We'll have slow growth. Job loss, the jobs that left. Remember, Obama said, "Well, you want to do take a magic wand, make the jobs
pretty good,"
and that's not going to happen because it does take more than a magic wand. It takes
smart man like President
it
Trump.
It takes tariffs, and to get these jobs back in America, these manufacturing jobs, it takes tariffs on the Chinese, and this is working. Everybody says that this economic war that we got with China is not working. It is working.
It's working.
And it's going to continue to work. And that's why the Chinese want Biden to win. And to make no mistake about it, they'll do everything in their power to get Biden to win, if possible.
Well, yeah. I mean, look at the sweetheart deal that they give Hunter. What do you think that was about, folks? That wasn't just a dog and pony show. That was Joe Biden selling out America to the Chi-Coms. Is exactly what they was buying influence to the president and vice president.
Enrich his family is what it was all about.
Yes.
How does somebody making $200,000 a year become a multimillionaire? How do they do that
right.
in office?
Right.
Just ask yourself, how does somebody become a multimillionaire that's in Congress or in
making $150,000 a year?
You know, it's a tough thing to do to become a multimillionaire, and it happens on the Republican side too, gang.
Oh yeah,
and that's why you got
absolutely.
That's why the deep state is there are a bunch of Republicans too involved in that deep state, and they don't like Donald Trump. You know why? Because he does the right thing.
Right.
And he does it because he loves America and he loves you and me. It's because he does it. He doesn't need the money. So he doesn't have
to
worry about
millions,
when he gets out of office, he doesn't have to worry about trying to make it rich or being paid off by countries that helped him in the past while he was president. There's no favors. There's nothing he has. He expects nothing from when he leaves office. See, and that's what every other president does. They make these deals while they're in office, change things, and then when they get out of office, that's when they get paid. Notice it happens every time.
All them donations that flow in for their presidential libraries and stuff.
Look at Bill Clinton and his wife.
Yeah.
She was. That's how they made their money off the Clinton Foundation, because they thought she would become president.
Yeah.
It never happened. And notice when it didn't happen, the money dried up. Nobody gives to the Clinton Foundation anymore.
Right. Well, how do you think that the Obamas went and bought a $15 million mansion up there in, what's the name of that place?
Martha's Vineyard.
Martha's Vineyard. It's through the back door, lying and cheating and selling out of America, Dave. And yes, it absolutely goes on the Republican side. There's sellouts, traitors, backstabbers, never Trumpers that are Republicans, the rhinos. Now, they all may not be thieves, okay, but there's plenty of never Trumpers in the Republican Party to go around. You've seen what John Kasich did, okay? You've seen what Mitt Romney's done. He's tried to be a stumbling block to him all the way. All right, and this little punk we got up here in Ohio, Mike DeWine, that crawled into bed, supposed to be, not literally, folks, I shouldn't have said it that way, but Amy Acton, okay, that was a fundraiser for Barack Obama and for Planned Parenthood, okay, Mike DeWine claims to be this big pro-life, pro-gun Republican, but yet he appoints her as the head of the Department of Health in the state of Ohio. She got so much heat over her lying and the deceiving through the COVID numbers, which are still going on to this day. 200-some-odd thousand people have not died strictly from COVID, David. It's 6% on average. About 10,000 people is all that's died in America strictly from the COVID.
Yeah, you die of a heart attack, a brain tumor, you name it, a stroke, a car wreck, a motorcycle wreck, anything, and you have COVID virus in your bloodstream, they're going to say the COVID is the cause of death, which is a bunch of crazy. That's crazy talk. Well, I know why they do it. They get
money.
Paid. They get paid.
$13,000.
And the Democrats set it up this way so that they could. They basically set Trump up a long time ago when they set up these programs, when they passed these laws that the government would give you more money for COVID. It's just exactly like what they did with unemployment. They gave you a $600 bonus. They wanted to keep you from working. That's the only reason they did it. They want to keep you out of work. So the economy would look bad for Trump when it comes to election time. But then what happened? It ran out, and they expect to hold Donald Trump hostage by saying, "Well, we're not. You let you do our deal. You all these bankrupt blue states and blue cities that these Democrats run for years. You pay them off, get their debt out of that paid off, and then we'll deal with you."
Right.
Trump said, "No, I'm not going to do that."
Well, you see, right now President Trump, he bent just he swayed just a little bit the other day. and offer her $1.something billion, okay? And he put a little bait on the hook, okay? But Pelosi didn't go for it, okay, to start another dialogue to get a package, a relief package through there. They, she don't want that.
No.
She don't want it. You know, that's why that she's doing this. But if she did get it, she wants all these failed cities and all these failed states to be bailed out because they've allowed Antifa to rob and to burn and to loot their cities. And not only that, Dave, a lot of these cities are bankrupt before Antifa ever busted the first window.
Well, look at New York. New York's going down the tubes. They're not last I heard was that Broadway's not going to open up until June or July of 2021. Now, all these restaurants are down through in Manhattan. They get paid from all. It's a chain reaction. When you stop the plays from being produced, and they're not anybody coming out in the evening, going to dinner, all these restaurants are going to be shut down. They can't, even if they have them, they've got to be at 25% capacity. Restaurants can't make any money like that. They have to work on a thin margin as it is. So when you knock them down to 25% occupancy, what happens is they can't pay their bills. They can't pay their help. They can't pay their electric. They can't pay their mortgage. They can't pay a lot of stuff because you've knocked them down intentionally. So what's going to happen? New York's going to go out of business. And once when they start leaving, they won't come back because people's finding out right now that you can work from home. Or as a matter of fact, you can work for these big companies and you can be in another state or another country with the online activities they've got now. All these Zoom deals you can do. You can meet people face-to-face through Zoom. All this technology has put cities in a bad predicament. Large cities are in a bad place because what's the advantage of working in a large city? Tell me. There's none. You got to pay high. There's high super rents. There's high. You can't.
Taxes.
There's traffic congestion, pollution. You can't get anywhere. The cost of living is sky high. Where you can live somewhere in Idaho, out in the mountains someplace, and very low cost of living, or even around here where we live, the cost of living's way down. You take $1 million here and buy a house, you can buy a nice house for $1 million.
Oh, yeah. Boy.
Go to New York City, Manhattan. What do you get for $1 million? You
apartment.
You get a tiny one-bedroom apartment.
Yeah.
That's maybe 800 square feet, if that. And you, why would anybody in their right mind do that? See, that's why cities, they're in trouble. They're not coming
Big
back.
Time,
these cities aren't coming back. You watch. Big they're not time. Coming back. They're dying. And I think the giant in New York City, the mayor, learned that. He's
going to cook them dinner if they come back, Doug.
Him and Cuomo, they've really cooked New York. I'll tell you what. What they did with the virus, they shut the city down. They shut the state down.
It killed thousands of old people.
And they put them all back in their nursing homes and just spread the disease all over the place and killed who knows how many people died. When they had the ship, Trump sent them the ship.
And the Javits Center.
The Javits Center was capable of carrying 1,000 patients in it. And the Army Corps of Engineers built that for them in no time.
Yeah.
And still they wouldn't use it. They sent them back to their nursing home.
Bush had Franklin Graham down in Central Park, and they run him out of there.
He was a homophobe.
Except,
you get out of here, you homophobe.
Yeah, they run
don't
him
you
off.
Come back here. We don't want your help.
You know, and then they sent all these elderly people. It was contagious right into the, as a matter of fact, Janice Dean, from the meteorologist from Fox.
Mother-in-law and father-in-law both died.
Both died because of that. And now, I don't know. I think there's some legal issues that she has going on there. And I pray that she does because them people need to be held accountable for that, David. The blood is on their hands. And they talk about Trump and how he handled the COVID. He's the only one done anything, David. What was it? 5 cases showed up here in the United States. I can't remember the date, January 29th.
The first cases appeared in Washington State.
And it shut it
around,
down.
I think it was around the end of January, something like the 26th or 25th of January.
Yeah.
But by the 31st, he stopped all travel from China.
Travel.
They call him
all kinds of racist
names, and they said you shouldn't do that. Then he shut the travel down from Europe and to New York, and they called him the same names again.
They come
and then now, what are they doing? They're changing their story, saying he didn't do enough.
Yeah,
and his blood is on his hands, and Joe Biden doesn't know if he's in a closet or not.
Yeah.
He doesn't know if he's in the daytime, if daytime or nighttime. He doesn't know if he's running for president. Today or yesterday, he said, "Well, I'm glad I'm running for the Senate," or something like that. Joe, it's president, yeah. not Senate.
Yeah. Yeah.
See, he's lost his mind. Yeah. And the way Trump says, he's shot. He is. That's an old saying. We used to go.
The man is sick.
He's shot. You know, Trump was right. He's shot. And he doesn't know where he is half the time. And you expect him to run our country? No. It ain't going to happen. But what's going to happen is a bunch of people are going to run right beside him and they're going to whisper in his ear and tell him exactly what to do.
Oh, yeah.
And he's just going to – all he's going to do is make a speech from the podium and read off the teleprompter if he can do that, if he gets elected. But I personally think Trump's got it made. He's going to win this election.
It's going to be a landslide, brother.
He's going to win this election. Well, I guarantee it.
It's just like this debate. The debate commission on their own, without consulting anybody, when President Trump come down with COVID and his staff and Melania, boom, all of a sudden, it's going to be virtual. It's going to be over the internet. They're in the bag for Joe Biden anyway, Dave. They are part of Legion, folks. Legion is the mainstream media, okay? That's who Legion is. They're all the same people, okay? And President Trump, I'm so glad, and I hope he sticks to his guns. He don't need these debates, no. David. They need him worse than he needs them.
That's the truth.
You know, and he just flat out told them, I'm not wasting my time with this. When people will sit there out of sight and feed Joe Biden a question.
They'd be holding big cue cards saying, Joe, say this. There'll be somebody with a marker writing the answer down.
You know what?
And then Joe will be saying, could you hold it closer so I can read it? I can't read it. Too far away. Too far away. Well, hold it a little bit closer.
He can't even be trusted to read cue cards. But that's exactly what's going to happen. Now, I'm going to say this. And this might be controversial, all right, to some people. But I'm gonna tell you the flat-out truth, all right. Joe Biden's family is pushing this, okay? His brother's under investigation. I don't know who else in the family's under investigation.
Yeah, he's got two brothers.
Are they both under investigation?
There's James and... I can't think of
I don't know who the other one is, but I know one of them's got some dirty business dealings. All right. And Joe Biden's wife, she is allowing this. She's part of the cabal pushing Joe Biden into this, David, for one reason, to protect her son, Hunter Biden. That's the mother's instinct. I really believe is what's driving her, because she knows that if the truth comes out and the indictments come out, that not only is Joe Biden they'll put him in a mental institution. But if Barr and Durham do their job, and I know there's a lot of questions about
that. How old is Hunter Biden?
I really don't know.
He almost 50?
I don't know. 48, something like that, maybe.
I don't think that's her boy. I think that was from the other marriage, the one the wife got killed and the daughter got killed.
Yeah.
I don't think that's her kids.
Well, maybe she's not then, David. Because her M.O.
I don't think she got married to him until like 75 or 76.
Well,
like
you
that.
Know what? You're correct. I stand corrected.
But
you're absolutely right. That's from Joe's first wife got killed in a car wreck.
Yeah. I think that was his mom that got killed in the car.
Absolutely. Right. Okay. Well, what's her M.O.?
Well, you're right about. I've noticed that.
Is
you
it
know how
she protect him or for the money.
I think it's both. I think what she wants is she wants the prestige. She wants to be in the White House. Did you see how she kind of guides him around, pulled him back
when
he was too close to the reporter? She pulled him back and then walked away.
Yeah,
it's just like if she could, she'd run herself.
Absolutely,
and I think that's what she's doing is she's running through him.
Yeah.
So she prompts him a lot of times, that's why they keep him off the campaign trail and out of the public as much as they can because there's no benefit to him. There's no benefit at all because all he's going to do is make a gaffe, but they're getting a lot worse.
He's a liability to them more than anything.
Like if Trump would have let him talk the night of that first debate, he would have talked himself into oblivion.
Oh, yeah.
He would have just kept talking.
He kept writing.
And then he would, and he talks and then he forgets what he's talking about.
Right.
And then he goes off on a tangent and you never know what point he was trying to make. And he doesn't know what point he's trying to make.
I'm glad you remind me of that, though, Dave. You're so right. And I don't know how that slipped my mind. I'm blaming on old age, but that ain't her son.
I don't think they had any kids first, together.
You know, and his other son, which was in the military, I think he was a captain or lieutenant. He's a captain. Bo, he died from the brain tumor.
Right.
You know, Joe's had it rough. He has lost a lot of family members. You know, and a son and a wife and.
Well, he's had two brain aneurysms.
You know, yeah.
I don't know if people out there know this, but he's had two brain aneurysms.
Right.
And that's serious, folks.
Yeah.
I mean, you can, it's like a stroke. You can die and you can be paralyzed. You can lose your memory. You can lose your cognitive skills. And who knows? He may have had a mini stroke. Maybe that's why he deteriorated so much after he left
so
the White
fast,
House.
Yeah.
Because he's not the same guy as he was 4 years ago.
He's not.
And even Obama said, "Hey, Joe, you don't have to do this. You don't have to run." But see, I think going back to your point, I think his family wanted him to.
I think
they pushed him. That's why he's in this thing, and he's got no business being in it. But who did Democrats have? They didn't have anyone else. So was it going to be Bernie, crazy Bernie against Trump? Trump would have ate him up. He's a communist.
Went to Moscow for his honeymoon.
Praised Cuba's health plan down there. They said their healthcare system was better than ours.
That's
crazy talk.
Yeah, you know how they cure a disease there in Cuba? A bullet in the head.
Right.
That's how they take care of that. Same way they do in North Korea.
Yeah, they had
a bullet in the head.
They apologized for killing those people with the COVID virus. They shot them because they disobeyed the their orders to stay inside. Who knows how many people's died from that COVID virus in North Korea? We'll never know.
Because
they just kill them and throw them in a big hole with a bulldozer and throw them in and bury them.
Right. But I tell you what, though, folks, I'm going to tell you something. Okay, Trump may not be the ideal picture of what me or you consider as a Christian. All right? Okay, but neither was a lot of people in the Bible, David. Every man, you're not so close to God that you don't have some problems, that you don't have some areas in your life where you need to pull up, okay? But here's the thing. God takes an imperfect thing and uses it for his perfect will, David.
That's exactly right, because look at Nebuchadnezzar. He was used by God to overrun Israel. He took Israel into captivity because of their idol worship.
Right.
Basically, they went off and started worshiping Baal and Moloch. And Moloch is a character. He was a big iron statue figure that was hollow on the inside, and they stoke it up with fire, and they take their babies and they put it in the Moloch fire and burn them alive, kill them. They burn their babies alive. We tend to kill ours in the womb. But it's the same difference.
Same spirit.
It's the same difference. I mean, if you kill them after they're born and you kill them in the womb, it doesn't make any difference. You're killing a baby. You're killing a baby either way you go. And this is where this country is going to have to they're going to have to pray and repent from this stuff. I heard a statistic. This is alarming. That in the state of New York, there's more kids aborted than born. Black kids are more black kids aborted than are born. Think about that for a second. They got negative population growth.
Wow. I didn't know that.
That's a crazy statistic. In the state of New York, more black babies are aborted than are born. And that's why the Hispanics are now the number one
minority group.
Well, yeah, they're number one minority in the United States, by quite a few. I mean, this is going to keep on happening. And abortion was made, they said, I don't know for sure, but they said it was a racist thing to begin with from the get-go to get rid of blacks. Was
Margaret Sanger.
Yeah, I've heard that for years.
Just research Margaret Sanger. If you're for abortion, research Margaret Sanger, David. She was a racist. Mm-hmm. She wanted to, she was into this eugenics, whatever you call it, like Hitler
right.
was, and the perfect society and all this. Okay, and so her goal was to eliminate the black race. Oh, she was the founder of Planned Parenthood. Okay, and so Margaret Sanger, if you're for abortion, you go look up Margaret Sanger. You just might be a racist, okay, because she tried to abolish the black race. Any other race, her first target was the black race, then it would have been everybody else. But here's the thing, David, there are 900, statistically, 900 black babies a day that's killed from abortion, all right, in the United States. Now, there are over 70 million babies altogether since Roe v. Wade. There's so much innocent blood that stained the soil of America. Repentance is our only way out, David.
Yeah.
It's our only way out is a sincere repentance, and it's the only way out from the judgment. I would not want to be in anybody's shoes that's going to stand before a righteous God that had anything to do with not trying to stop this. And when it comes to President Trump, there's never been a more pro-life president, I don't believe, in the history.
As you know, the Bible says, speaks a little bit on this subject that we're talking about abortion. And it's in Proverbs chapter 6, starting verse 16. It says, "These six things the Lord hates." Yes. "Seven are an abomination to him." And this first one is a proud look. Next is a lying tongue. This one's interesting. Hands that shed innocent blood.
Ooh.
How much more innocent can you get than the unborn? You kill them before they're born.
Jesus is as close to the best answer you have for that, David.
Another one is a heart that devises wicked plans.
Oh, got them.
Feet that are swift and running to evil.
Got them.
A false witness who speaks lies.
You've seen that today on TV.
We got that in the whole Democrat Party.
And the mainstream legion.
And one who sows discord among the brethren.
No, boy.
Those are the things that God hates. Now, if you repent from these things, God's not going to hate you no more. So it just makes sense that we can't keep doing what we're doing and expecting a different result.
Right.
It's not going to happen.
Right.
And as we said earlier, Donald Trump, he's not a Sunday school teacher. He's not a pastor. He's president of the United States. And he's still trying to do what's best for this country, put America first. Now, there's nothing wrong with that.
No.
And it's time this country wakes up and smells the coffee. That the Democrat Party is not going to take us anywhere. Look at everywhere that in every state where they hold domination in California, Oregon, Washington, Illinois, New York, all the east, all the northeast, Maine, you know, Connecticut, New Hampshire, Vermont, all these states, Rhode Island, all these states where they control Delaware, you take all these states, they run them into the ground. Every single one of them. They're all in debt. All their pension programs are all super in debt because they spend money that they don't have and they love to do it. And because states can't print their own money like the federal government can, they're in serious trouble. And that's why Pelosi is looking ahead in the future for Democrats. If these states go bankrupt, what's going to happen? These people might start voting Republican and be saying, "Well, we got to lose." Remember what Trump said to the blacks? "Well, you got to lose." And eventually that's going to happen because they're going to get in such bad shape from mismanagement that they're going to start voting Republican. Because obviously when you've had Democrats in control for 20, 30, 40, 50 years and it's not working, it goes back to what Einstein said. You know, you keep doing the same thing over and over expecting a different result is a definition of insanity. And that's where we are in this country. I don't understand why they keep voting for these people over and over and over and over again, and nothing ever changes. And Trump comes along, that's why they hate him, because he fights back and he gives common sense answers to problems that we have. And you know what? The common sense answers work.
He knows how to fix it.
He knows how to fix things, and he knows how to build things, and he knows how to organize, and he knows how to run things. And if he doesn't get results, you're out the door. He fires you. He don't keep you. He gets rid of you. Look how – that's why he fires so many people, because they don't do the job. He says they're lazy.
That's right.
His first Secretary of State, you know what he said about him? He's lazy as can be. He said that was a mistake ever hiring him.
Yeah.
He was just lazy as could be, and he fired him. He did the right thing because he didn't know what he was doing. He was lazy. But if you try and you work hard, you can make something out of yourself in this country. Anybody can do it. I could have done a lot better in life than I did. But I did all right. But I didn't work exceptionally hard, but I worked, you know, there was from years there, I worked 6 days a week. I did it every, it was just normal for me. I worked 6 days a week, every week, week after week after week, unless I was on vacation. I did it and I did it and I did it. And I did it over and over and over again. It just became normal for me. I worked 6 days a week. I mean, I could have worked, and there's times I even worked 7 days a week. But, you know, that gets old without a day off. But
you done what you had to do.
I did what I had to do, and I'm glad I did, because now I'm retired. I got a decent retirement.
Yeah, that's the American spirit. That's what the Democrats is out to kill. Okay, that's why they want to, cradle to grave, care for people. You know, they want to deceive you into, hey, we can take care of you. We can provide this medical care. We can provide you with an abortion. We'll give you welfare. We'll give you free education. One of the worst things that our federal government ever done, David, was start handing out student loans to the American people. That's one of the worst things that they could have ever done. You know, when that program started, it was for the veterans, okay, to get these veterans and combat vets re-educated and get them back out to work. Then they expanded it to the general public. Now what happened to the tuition? Look what happened.
And
that's why it's government money.
And that's why these schools have so much money in their endowments, and all this money they got stocked away, billions of dollars, like Harvard and Yale, and all these big Ivy League schools. They've got all this money socked away because they don't need it, because tuitions are so high, and they keep raising and raising and raising because the government backs them. And right. and these students are the ones who are the flunkies or the dummies that keep
worthless degrees.
They get these degrees that they can't do anything with.
Liberal arts.
They can't find a job. Well, what kind of job are you going to do with a liberal arts degree?
One in 100,000 probably wind up with a job.
You really basically don't know how to do anything. You don't know how to do anything. And a lot of these students, they just become professional students. They go to school way into their 40s.
Right.
Or they go into politics because they don't want a real job. And a lot of these politicians, that's all they've done their entire life. Well, Joe Biden.
He's been a politician
since 1973. Think about that. 1973. There's a lot of these people weren't even born when he started in politics. Now he's almost 78 years old, will be in November, 78 years old, and never done anything but politics his entire life. Got a law degree and was last in his class or near the end of his class, and lied about it and said he was at the top of his class.
And he went to black college.
Then he plagiarized from Neil Kinnock, the Labor Party over in Great Britain, stole his resume.
Yeah,
stole it word for word. Yeah. Didn't even modify it. That's how stupid he is. That's why Trump said, "Hey, he's in prime time. He wasn't that smart, and he sure ain't that smart now. He's shot." This is like Trump said. He's shot. The guy is shot, And I can't believe this country would vote for this clown. And I don't care what the polls say. If he's 10 points ahead, 20 points ahead, he will not win this election. He's dumb, stupid. There can't be that many Americans that see that cannot see that. They have to see it.
Right. And I don't understand that either, Dave. Even us as voters, what is best for America? Trump's accomplishments. There's that tickleback. With all the opposition from before he was elected, from before, as soon as he come down that escalator, and this has been said so many times, the man ain't seen one day of peace. He ain't seen one day to where he don't have somebody lying on him, blaspheming against him, calling him everything in the book, calling his family. They even went after Barron Trump. None of his family sees a minute's peace. But yet he quit a multi-billion-dollar job, don't even get paid for being president, donates his $400,000 a year to different departments in the government and other things. And this is the kind of thanks he get. Folks, even with all the opposition, even fighting Congress tooth and nail the whole way, his accomplishments, David, has outdone many of presidents up to today, the accomplishments that he has. Look what he's done for Israel alone, David. Yeah. I mean, you know, all the rest of them talked about it and bragged about how they're going to do it. He is a man. He wants results. He demands results, David. And he stepped right into this position, losing millions of dollars every day, every year, and done what the others couldn't do. Right. They wasn't smart enough.
Amen.
They wasn't, right on, Jimmy. They wasn't intelligent enough to do it. They stuck their thumb up their hind end and sat on it and give this country away, and Republicans are to blame just as much as anybody else. The man can't be bought. He can't be bribed. He can't be persuaded. I think he's the most honest man. Who in history of America has had the anal exam that he's had through crooked Hillary and these crooked FBI agents that have accused him of what they've accused him of, and he come out smelling like a rose, brother? Who else can stand up to that kind of examination or scrutiny and come out squeaky clean?
I don't think anybody could. I heard this guy on Rush Limbaugh today. He's probably in his 80s. He said he voted his first election. He voted for Eisenhower. And I thought, wow, this guy's pretty old. I thought I was old. But he had to have been in his 80s because he voted for Eisenhower. Eisenhower was, president when I was born. So this guy's probably got me by about 20 years. He's probably mid to upper 80s. He said he voted for Eisenhower. And he said this. I listened to him. He goes, of all the presidents, including Ronald Reagan, he goes, I've heard them all. He goes, Donald Trump is the best president I've seen in my lifetime. And I agree with that. If you take his accomplishments, I mean, Reagan was a good man. He was a good president. He was a good man. But he didn't accomplish what Donald Trump has accomplished in 4 years. I mean, it's amazing. All the stuff he's accomplished. And I do believe that's because of his management style. And he wants things to get done. And you must perform when you work for him, or he will get rid of you. And if you don't do the job, he will get rid of you. It's as simple as that.
Yeah.
He does. And he knows how to manage people. And he knows how to get the most out of people. And he knows what he wants to do. He's a man of action. And he loves this country. That's the most important thing about Donald Trump. You can see it. You can hear it. He loves this country. And the people see that in him. They see he's authentic, and he means what he says, and he says what he means. He's a man of integrity, and that's why the people love him so much. And these scandals, so-called scandals that the Democrats are trying to unveil on him every single day, it just doesn't work because the people, his base loves him, and I love him. And I wouldn't take anything for him. And right. I'll tell you what, if time lasts, you will look back on these days, and I guarantee you, you'll say those were the good old days, the days that we're in right now. Because things went without Donald Trump here and without control of the Congress and the courts, this country will go straight to hell.
Yep.
I'm serious.
Without
and
the
it,
hand
and it will go fast. This country will go down the tube so quick that you won't even realize it. And you'll look back on these days and you'll say those were the good old days back when Donald Trump was president, and you'll miss him. I guarantee it, and I guarantee that'll happen. You just watch.
Yeah.
These are the good old days you're living in right now, folks. So get out and vote. Vote. Vote for Trump.
Vote for Trump. Absolutely. Vote for Trump. Folks, our nation is at stake. Everything that you held dear in this country is at stake, right down to the Pledge of Allegiance, right down to your prayers. And that reminds me, you praying people out there, never forget to pray for a president and his family. David, I tell you, when he come back from the hospital and he walked up them stairs to that balcony, mm-hmm. Now this is how I felt about it, folks. This man has been handpicked by God, I don't care who says what. For this time, for this era in America, he is handpicked by God.
God even prepared his healing ahead of time.
Exactly.
By that drug that he took, that experimental drug. Do you see how quick he recovered from
Boom.
It? Within one day. And Trump was the one that approved this a long time ago, the right to try that,
right.
that legislation
right
for experimental drugs. This is part of his own legislation. So he had a hand in saving himself. But I think God was behind that. I really do. I'm with you on that. He was behind that because when he walked up them steps, he was getting bad. If he hadn't took that new experimental drug, he would have been, I'd say he'd been a goner.
He could have been.
Because I'll tell you, at his age, he would have been in bad shape. But that drug, it made him feel so much better. He said he felt 20 years younger. So it works. And I hope everybody gets an opportunity to use it.
And he wants the same treatment, David, for you and for me and for your neighbor, for your children, for your grandma, for your grandpa. That's not just something he wants to hoard up for himself. He loves you. He loves this country. He loves America. He loves our institutions, David. He loves our Constitution. Okay, his parents come from nothing, and the American dream and their hard work and their prayers catapulted them to where they was that made Trump the man he is. But God ordained that man, I really believe this, from the beginning of time to be where he is right now, David, to do things that nobody else could do, to do things that nobody else cared about doing, and to stop the bleeding in this country. America, you've got another swing at the bat. David, I honestly believe that this time period is a time for America to turn her heart back to God, to look at where we come from, look at who we are, look at what we stand for. Look what we let slip away. Look what we allowed Satan to steal from us, David. Right down to where we're killing the most precious. The womb used to be the safest place for a child, David, but not anymore. That's how far we've slipped in this country. And it just... You know, this is our last gasp. I really believe that, David, that this is our opportunity. And I tell you what, when the time comes, we're going to wish we had 4-8 more years of President Trump. Folks, and you better be praying that God will send somebody after this next 4 years of President Trump, that the Lord will prepare a Trump-like candidate, David, to carry this country on. Because we cannot continue in the sin and the trash and the garbage that's what our Congress and what our leaders are allowing to happen. He's a one man. He's like, it's like a battle royal, David, and he's the, and they're all against him. He's fighting the media. He's fighting some of his own people. He's fighting the Democratic Party. He's, you know, on every hand, the man without me and you folks behind him and supporting him, he stands alone.
Look where the Democrats.
Except for us.
Look where the Democrats are. What, you know what they're worried about? They're worried about abortion. So Amy Coney Barrett, they're you know what they're talking about? They want to find out from her what she her views on abortion are. And if she is against abortion, they're against her.
Right.
And same thing with a gay marriage or whatever. Everything,
healthcare.
Everything that they call it health care for women,
yeah.
But I call it death care for babies.
Death care
for babies. I mean, there's no other way to look at it.
Murder chamber.
They're killing, and the Democrats are worried about their right to continue to kill.
That's right.
And that's why they're going to drill her and grill her and get her to say something or try to make a mistake. And you watch that tomorrow. Watch what how the questions they ask are will be with scowls on their face, anger, hatred in their eyes and on their face.
Well, here's the thing. We've got 1 minute, Dave. Here's the thing. The commentators, even on Fox, oh, the Democrats, they'll be docile. They'll tune it down. They don't want America.
They can't help themselves.
They can't help themselves. They're so evil, David. Folks, stay tuned. Watch those hearings tomorrow. The devil will, I guarantee you, he'll show his face.
He'll show himself.
Folks, this is Les Sky Moan and Dave on a new night, Monday night. Thank you for joining us. We love you. God bless you. Thank you on Facebook. And tune in again next Monday, 7 p.m. Les Sky Moan and Dave. Take us on out, Jimmy. Thank you, brother. See you, Paul. And we're still on the air.
What happened? Revolution, gun control, the sound of soap. Shooting rockets to the moon, kids going up to soon. Politicians say more taxes will solve everything. And the